I certainly appreciate the opportunity to be here today and to maybe give you a very brief update on some Lake Powell issues. And I thought it might be appropriate to talk a little about cost and project financing, and maybe at the very end I'll briefly talk about where we're at in our current planning process. This is a overview of what the district has in current facilities. And you can see we have facilities that go all the way from Iron County clear over to Gunlock. I was in a meeting recently and someone said once that water infrastructure is a lifeline of civilization. You really think about it, and it really is that. And you know what? I've loaded the wrong PowerPoint here, Barbara.
It's her fault.
But it's sure pretty pictures.
Those are pretty pictures, and I'd love to talk all day about groundwater recharge and some other issues, but let me see if I can find the right one here.
You'll have to check up on him next time, Barbara.
I don't think I can supervise that closely.
You know how it is sometimes. Here we go.
Looks like you're getting warm.
In Lake Powell, of course, there are three water districts. There are three counties that are involved in this project. And so as we look at how the project is going to be split up, Kane County, of course, takes the water out first. Then the water is split at the top of the Hurricane Cliffs. Part of it will go into Iron County, and the lion's share will come into Washington County. Those costs are allocated among the counties based on the sections of the pipeline. So from the Lake Powell outlet to the Kane County valve, Kane County will pay 4.7%. Iron County pays 15% of the Kane County valve, and we pay 80.3%. From the Kane County valve to the Iron County valve, which is top of the Hurricane Cliff, Iron County will pay 15.9%, and we pay 84.3%. That doesn't seem to me like that quite matches up, so I've got a small error there. Each district then will pay from where its outlet is, pays 100% of the costs from there on. So for example, from the top of the Hurricane Cliffs to Cedar City will be an Iron County cost. From the Kane County outlet to theirs will be a Kane County cost, and from the top of the Hurricane Cliff to Sand Hollow Reservoir will be a district cost. When you put those all together, the current estimated cost of the project is slightly over $1 billion. Washington County share of that is $694 million. Now, in the water industry, we do everything by cost per 1,000 gallons. Which is how we deliver water to our cities. And so as you look at the cost for the Washington County portion, it's about $1.42 for the capital cost. We ultimately expect to pay for that with impact fees. There will be a charge from Bureau of Reclamation estimated at about 23 cents a thousand. Cost of pump will be about 40 cents a thousand. The O&M costs about 3 cents, repair and replacement 3 cents. We expect to produce hydropower revenues from the small plants of about 20 cents a thousand, and there's the potential to generate as much as $1.64 a thousand off of the pump storage. The capital cost of the water coming to the county will be about $9,371 per acre foot. And so, you know, when you look at that, I was in meetings last week where where there were discussions of several big projects, and frankly, as I listened to him, I thought, you know, maybe Powell's really a pretty big steal, because in Colorado they have three or four large projects in the $1 to $6 billion range, and they're looking between $17,000 to $40,000 an acre foot on those projects.
How does that compare with our current water costs, Ron?
Our current water's costing us somewhere around $3,000 to $4,000 for capital projects to develop today. Two and a half times. Of course, the O&M revenues are expected to offset the repair and replacement costs, primarily for Washington, some in Iron County. And Ultimately, this project we expect to be financed by the state. We will repay that over a 50-year period. In the first 10 years, for each block you take down, you have 50 years from the date that block is taken down at 4% interest. If it goes beyond that, then the term ends up being shortened. We expect in our county, if we continue to grow as has been projected, that we would take this down in smaller blocks, and likely with our impact fee or regional water supply contracts, we will pay for that as we take it down. I think two things I would say that I think are fairly important. Lake Powell takes us out to a population of around 450,000 people. It probably will meet our water supply needs into the mid to late 2030s. And you know, I hear people say we've quit growing, but our experience in the district is today we're delivering about 31 million gallons a day to the core cities from, primarily to St. George, Santa Clara, Ivins, and Washington, and another 1.5 million into the east side of the county. Our experience is that growth continues, even though our per capita use has declined, our use in total has continued to increase. We're seeing a level of somewhere around 600 to 800 building permits a year. We're slightly ahead this year over where we were last year in terms of impact fees to the district. And if you have each home takes about 0.89 acre foot of water. So if you're building 800 homes a year, you're almost 800 acre foot of new water allocation that you have to meet your long-term needs in this county. As we look at our current projects and what has to come on before this, it's crystal clear to us that by the early 2020s, this project has to be online. We've got to look at much more expensive measures to meet the long-term needs so that there's water for future generations here. So anyway, I thought it would be worthwhile for the commissioners to at least have some feel of where we see this project moving. And it is moving along. We're now, most of the early environmental studies have been completed. We've had comments come back. The comments that came back were from the federal agencies who only have to issue the permits, had some comments on the drafts which are being addressed. We had 4 or 5 environmental organizations and 11 individuals who commented on the draft study plans, and those are now, our response have gone in, and FERC will review those and decide if there's got to be changes to the study plans or if they're adequate.
What's the timeline on that, Ron?
We think in late 2012, maybe 2013 now, we'll see the EIS that FERC will prepare come out, and we'll get a record of decision. And then we'll go into design. The project today is about 30% designed. And so we'll move into design and final financing. There is right now a group in the state working, a legislative task force group working on long-term financing, of which the two state projects that are approved is on that agenda. One is this, and of course the other is the Bear River project. And so, you know, I think the project's following exactly how it needs, the course it needs to follow to come online, as we're going to need it in this county. That's all I really have today. If there are other questions, I'd be glad to answer them from the commission.
I just appreciate the fact that we're still planning ahead. I mean, Quail Lake, Sand Hollow have made what we've got today, and without Lake Powell, I don't think we're going to have the same opportunities in the future. And appreciate the Water Conservancy District being in the forefront in the planning of that.
Well, and additionally, I think you could probably make a strong case for the need we need to have for redundancy in now. I mean, this present day, our current population, we need redundant supplies in all things with power and certainly other energies as well as water. So I think it's a good message and one we need to consider as a community together and move forward with it and get it done.
Thank you.
Yep.